Uh-oh. I'm ready. I'm ready. Da-dee-doo.
So, most people giving this toast have known either the bride or groom for a very long time and met the other through their friend. Well, not me. I actually knew Matt and Katie for the exact same amount of time. I met both of them freshman year of high school and instantly became great friends. I bet I know what you're thinking right now. Obviously, I set them up. Unfortunately, I cannot take the credit for that. Not just the catch of the day, not just a passing phase. You gotta hold on me in every
way. I be kind. Dear Katie, it's finally here. Can you believe it? In just a few moments, you will be walking down the aisle and every dream that I ever had for myself will finally become reality. I honestly cannot wait to see you at the altar because that moment will definitely be the moment that I will cherish for life. I'm so proud to be able to soon call you my wife. You're everything I ever wanted and our life together is going to be a blast. My wedding gift to you is a symbolic and marks the beginning of our adventure together that has been a blast and it certainly will always be a blast, forever and ever. I hope you like it because it truly says 1,000 words about how I feel about you. You are absolutely everything to me, and I wouldn't be who I am today without you in my life. I love you, Katie Rook. Now get down the aisle so I can kiss my bride. Love always, your husband now. Simple and true, you're my honeymoon. Oh, oh, not just the catch of the day.
Coming back from spring break and having a bunch of my high school friends over. Much to my surprise, I see Katie J, now Katie Rook, walking through the door and discover that she and Matt had become good friends. They were both going to Wilkes University and were spending a lot of time together. Katie was also like a sister to me, or always like a sister to me. Our friendship grew so quickly, mainly for the reason that at ISLI, we found out that we lived right across the river from each other. We hung out almost every weekend, and Katie loved writing me notes. Notes that you would normally write in class and give to your friend in the hall, except she would wait until the next time we hung out. And even when I was in college, she would mail them to me. In fact, we were so close that I was even her prom date one year in high school, where she tried to teach me how to dance to Pop, Lock, and Drop It. We practiced for weeks beforehand, and when it came time to do it at the prom, Katie nailed it, of course, because she's a great dancer, and I ended up on the floor. I couldn't quite get the drop it and then come back up. Katie and I came up with 3 ways of how you know you like a guy. They were simple but true. He's the first thing you think of when you wake up, the last thing on your mind when you fall asleep, and you can't stop thinking about him throughout the day. When Katie first told me she liked Matt, I knew it was real. Obviously, it fulfilled all 3 of the requirements, so it had to be true. But it was so much more than just that. Their love is so easy to see and believe. It has been incredible to be able to see their love grow. From being friends to dating, to engaged, and now to husband and wife.
I've said to myself, this affair, it never will go so well. But why should I try to resist when, baby, I know damn well that I've got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice comes in the night and repeats in my ear.
The two of them coming together just makes sense. I once heard the saying that made me think of Katie and Matt. Getting married is not about finding someone you can live with. It's about finding someone you can't live without. So let's raise our glasses to Matt and Katie, to a life full of love and happiness forever. Love you guys. Cheers.
Sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice comes in the night and repeats how it yells in my ear. Don't you know, you fool, ain't no chance to win. Why not use your mentality? Get up, wake up to reality. Thought of you makes me stop just before I begin, because I've got you.
So I am Steven, I am Matt's brother, younger brother, and I younger. I'm definitely not littler than him or more little, but I'm not an English teacher, I'm a math teacher, so don't mind me. But throughout growing up, mine and my brother's fondest memories came in our family vacation spot of Walt Disney World, which Katie got to experience. And as most of you know, Matt themed his proposal to Katie on their favorite Disney movie, Up. In Up, there is a quote that I find very fitting for today, and it says, "We love not by finding a perfect person, but by learning how to love someone who is imperfect perfectly." And that's exactly what Matt and Katie did today. And we are here to celebrate that. And I feel alive for the first time in my life. Oh baby, I feel alive tonight. You lift me up. Never seen you happier than anybody else other than Katie, and I've definitely never seen him go out of his way for anyone else other than Katie. So that is how I know, Matt, you truly love Katie. And Katie, ever since my first day freshman year on Wilkes campus, that I called you my on-campus mom, for any problems I may have had, I went straight to Katie. I knew from that day on, Katie, you were part of the family. only other words I have for you two is to wish you both a happy, loving life. You both chose great people to continue your adventure book with. And never stop loving each other or going out of your way to make each other happy. Because as Bambi has told us, love is a song that never ends. To my new sister, I love you.